Good morning, my friends. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Para panuchun yerkenk, para tsainer hanchetsenenk, of sana, of sana karin astudzo. Yes, I'm singing in Armenian, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Lamb of the Lord, of God, the Lamb that comes in the name of the Lord. They were shouting Hosanna, Hosanna that day, which means save us, save us. And then they said, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And we see this Palm Sunday celebration. We see it in every one of the Gospels. And when yesterday Benjamin brought up chapter 19 of Luke, I just want to bring up a few points from the message yesterday. Because yesterday my heart was so filled with joy that not only were people celebrating Palm Sunday, the first day of the week, the Sunday that we can go to church, but churches were being opened up around the world. I even saw pictures from Lebanon that they had gone into the church. And yes, I want to make sure you know, churches never close. Jesus is the one who has brought the church, the body of Christ that we are. We have never been shut down. We are still praising him. But the church, the building was shut down. And yesterday I was watching the celebration in Jerusalem live as a brother was reporting, and he was walking from Mount of Olives down into Jerusalem where Jesus would have gone on his triumphant entry into Jerusalem. But of course, Jesus knew he was coming down to go into Jerusalem to be crucified. He knew that, but it says, for the joy set before him, he endured the cross. He knew the joy that resurrection was coming, but he went through the sacrifice. He went through the horrible crucifixion for you and I because he loved us so much. And he came, yes, to save us. They were shouting, Hosanna, save us, thinking that he was going to be the king to save them from the Roman Empire that was their enemy. But they didn't know. Jesus in chapter 19, verse 10 said, for the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. They thought it was just from that one problem, but Jesus had come to save them from their sins, to save them from death, to save them from what the enemy had brought in our way, because we were going to everlasting destruction, and he came to bring us everlasting life. And it says in Hebrews 7:25, he is able to save us to the uttermost. And then in Ephesians 3:20, I love that verse. And Daddy would give it to me so many times because it says, God is able to do far above, exceedingly beyond what we can imagine or think. So we are asking the Lord for this, and he's going to give us so much more than what we are asking him for. And this morning, I want to bring up a few points that Benjamin brought up. One of them was, of course, the part where Jesus sends his disciples to go into the village. It's in, it's in chapter 19 of Luke and verses 30 and 31. Go into the village against the right there where you will, as you're entering in, you will find a colt tied wherein no man has ever sat. Jesus knew the details of where he was sending his disciples. He already knew where this colt was tied, and he already knew where was the entering in of the village where they were. And he said, go and bring him to me. And if any man asks you, tell them, because the Lord has need of him. And this is the sentence he brought up where it said, the Lord needed that donkey. And he said, the Lord needs you and I today. He needs you and I today for the works he's prepared for us. Each one of us. It says, Ephesians 2:10 says, we are his workmanship created unto good works. So the Lord has prepared good works for us, and each one of us are individuals that we need not be like any other person. Jesus said, shine your light so others can see your good works and will glorify the Heavenly Father who's in heaven. So today we are fearfully and wonderfully made. Psalms 139 verse 14 says, we are fearfully, each one of us, and we are prepared unto good works so that we can do them. And we need to be faithful. Benjamin said, when the Lord needs you, be faithful with what he's given you. Be faithful with it, because he who is faithful with little, the Lord will give much. So today I want to encourage you. Yes, Lord, save us. If you've never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, ask him to save you from your sin and give him the robe of righteousness. Give him, he will give you the robe of righteousness, and he will give you everlasting life. So ask him for that. And if you are saved and walking with the Lord Jesus Christ, do the works that God has prepared for you personally, individually, because we are called to do the works he's prepared for us. We are his workmanship. And remember to be faithful with whatever he's given you, because when you are faithful, he will give you more. And today, remember, he is, blessed is he who has come in the name of the Lord. He is our King of Kings that comes and reigns in our hearts forever. So celebrate that today. Be blessed today.